This video is part of Microsoft's Getting Started on Azure video series for startups. In this video, we'll create one of the foundation components for a virtual machine and all services in Azure, the storage account. For example, when you create a virtual machine, its disks actually reside in the storage account. When looking at storage options, you need something that's redundant, fast, and scalable. Azure Storage gives you this foundation, plus several other benefits. Azure Storage is massively scalable, so you can store and process hundreds of terabytes of data to support big data scenarios. Azure Storage is also elastic. You can scale up when you need it, then scale back when you don't, and you only pay for what you use. Azure Table, Queue, and File Storage meet the growing demands of your application with an auto-partitioning system that automatically load balances data based on traffic. Azure Storage is accessible from anywhere in the world, from any type of application, whether it's running in the cloud or on-premises, across desktop, mobile, and tablet devices. Let's start creating the storage account. In the Azure portal, click New. Then, click Storage and click Storage Account. Enter a name for your storage account. The name needs to be between 3 and 24 characters long. You can use numbers, but letters have to be lowercase. To deploy this account into your existing resource group, click Resource Manager. Next, you'll select the type of storage account, general purpose or blob storage. A general purpose storage account gives you access to Azure storage services such as tables, queues, files, blobs, and Azure virtual machine disks under a single account. This type of storage account has two performance tiers from which you'll need to choose one. A standard storage performance tier that lets you store tables, queues, files, blobs, and Azure Virtual Machine disks. A premium storage performance tier, which currently only supports Azure Virtual Machine disks. Blob storage accounts are specialized for storing unstructured data as objects. These accounts are similar to general purpose storage accounts, but the main advantage of blob storage is the storage of applications requiring only block or append blob storage. Blob storage accounts are organized into access tiers as opposed to performance tiers. These tiers indicate which pieces of objects will be used more frequently. A hot access tier is for objects in the storage account that are more frequently accessed. This lets you store data at a lower access cost. A cool access tier is for objects that are less frequently accessed. This lets you store data at a lower storage cost. Blob storage allows for a change in the usage pattern of your data, meaning you can switch between these access tiers at any time. We'll select the general purpose storage account. This is the most common type of storage account. Next, select the application option you want. Azure storage accounts are always replicated to ensure high availability, so you never have to worry about your data. When you create a storage account, you'll select a region, which is a geographic location for the service availability, and you'll choose one of the replication options. Locally redundant storage replicates your data within the region of your account. All requests against your data are replicated 3 times and reside in 3 separate fault domains to ensure maximum durability. Zone redundant storage replicates data across 2 or 3 facilities, either within a single region or across 2 regions, providing even greater durability than locally redundant storage. Geo-redundant storage replicates data to a secondary region hundreds of miles away from the primary region. Read-access geo-redundant storage maximizes availability by providing read-only access to the data in a secondary location, in addition to replication across 2 regions. If your data becomes unavailable in the primary region, your application can read from the secondary region. We'll select the default read-access geo-redundant storage. Let's continue with creating the storage account. Next, select the subscription in which you want to create the new storage account. Next, you're going to choose an existing resource group or make a new one. Since we already created the empty resource group, choose this one. Select the region for your storage account, or just go with the default location specified by your selected resource group. Finally, click Create, and your storage account is ready. You can view each component of your storage account from the Azure portal. Or you can use an external Storage Explorer application. If you use a Storage Explorer application, you'll probably need to update the storage key used by those applications. When you create a storage account, Azure generates two 512-bit storage access keys, which are used for authentication when the storage account is accessed. Here you can view, copy, or regenerate your account access keys. The access keys blade also includes pre-configured connection strings for your primary and secondary keys to use in your applications. These can be accessed via the icon for each key. Removing a storage account that you're no longer using is similar to deleting a resource group. Just navigate to the storage account in the Azure portal and click Delete. You'll be prompted to type in the name of the storage account to confirm the deletion. But remember, deleting a storage account deletes the entire account, including all the data in the account. This concludes the video on storage accounts. Be sure to check out the other videos in this series. For more information and useful resources, visit startups.microsoft.com. Thank you for watching this video.